In the most recent video I put out, I made a glancing mention to the idea of the solar panel and pumps that we were using to pull water from this freshly dug pond. And folks indicated that there was a lot of interest in learning more about that. So in this video, I'm going to focus on this topic in particular, with the key ingredient being the least number of moving parts, the most simplified explanation, so you can get started with this quickly. So stick around. Now, of course, you're welcome to make this more complex if you want to, but this video is really intended for folks that feel either a little nervous about electricity, about solar, or feel like it's just something they don't understand. That's truly where I began with this. I have no background in electric. You'll see that very clearly in short order, but it works just fine. What I was taught very recently is that solar, especially a 12-volt solar system, which is the most ubiquitous standards that are out there, it's nearly impossible to be injured by electricity flowing through the cable. So it's not as though you'll get electrocuted or anything like that. It's very safe. And what we use are two ingredients. This is a bilge pump. Now, you can find these used on eBay. You can find them new on eBay. Please don't buy them from Amazon. Don't buy any of this stuff from Amazon. You can find it used or low price through a seller on eBay, or you might be able to find it for free locally. Do you live near a large body of water? There might be a marina. That's where these are normally used, is in boats. And in this case, I'm using a Rule bilge pump. And what this costs, about $22 brand new, $25. This is a 500 gallon per hour. I'm not gonna get too deep into that, but this only is true if you're lifting 0 feet. So if you've got a small body of water where you're lifting a handful of feet, let's say less than 10 feet, this is a reasonable pump, but it drops off pretty quickly with the rate of flow the higher you go. Anyway, 500 to 1,000 gallons per hour is probably all you need. And this can be connected directly to a solar panel in the sun. Now, this is a woefully undersized solar panel for this pump, but it works well enough if there's full sun. This is a 12-volt solar 12-volt bilge pump that requires 25 watts or so. That's what it says on the website. This is a 12-volt solar panel that generates 20 watts. So it doesn't actually meet the full need. But here's the beautiful part with this kind of stuff. These pumps can handle less voltage, a little over voltage, a little higher amps, a little lower amps. As long as it's in the ballpark, it'll work just fine. So what you're looking for is a bilge pump for less than $30, or making cold calls to marinas or other places where these might exist, and a solar panel, let's say between 25, 50, maybe even 100 watts, but no more. And in this case, all I'm using, this is old extension cable from an old lamp. You don't need to buy new wiring for this. Very simply twisted in there with some screws. That's sturdy enough. If it falls out, I can fix that. And we get this from our local reuse center. Talk to electricians. Maybe you can call a place that does electrical work. You can get these for free, for sure. And that's just wired in. And then on the other end, where it connects to the pump, we are now using these fancy Anderson power poles, but let me show you an even simpler way to do it. So these are lovely, and if there's enough interest, I will make a video about how we are working with these, but it requires a crimping tool, it requires a certain cutting tool, it's a bit of an investment, and unless you're making more than one of these, or if you've got a group of friends that wanna go in on this together, I would skip this for now. What I've used for almost a decade, and it worked just fine, are simple alligator clips. Very low tech, and those that do this sort of work or really understand it, we're probably laughing a little bit right now, and that's fine. You can laugh at me, but it has worked, and for those of you just getting into it, this is a great way to begin. These you can get from a local hardware store very easily. If need be, you can find them online, and they let you feed in a wire and use a little screwdriver just to lock it down. Very elegantly done, as you can see here. And black is negative, red is positive, and on your solar panel, they should tell you which one is negative and which one is positive. And so you would just follow that line, mark it clearly. And instead of having a termination like this, or like this on our extension cord, it could simply be cut. You could use a pair of pliers. You don't need a special tool. And you just need to expose a little bit of the wire. You can use a knife to do that. And you would clip the black wire onto the black lead, put your pump in the water, and then clip your red clip onto your red lead. And as long as the solar panel is in full sun, and it's roughly appropriate that it's a 12 volt pump with a 12 volt panel with a wattage that's around what the pump needs, it should start running. A little gotcha that you need to be aware of: each one of these sorts of bilge pumps, and I will say, as a fundamental rule, I'm gonna recommend strongly the bilge as a unit. We've worked with these for about a decade. They can pull up debris and material. They don't seem to clog. They've gone through incredible adversity with the way we've used them, and they keep on running. So this is a really nice way to go. But most of them have a weird fitting. So when you, if you're ordering one online or if you're finding one at a local store, you need to know what the hose fitting is that it needs. And in this case, it was a 3/4 inch. So I found a scrap of old plastic, used a hose clamp, and then got a fitting from the local hardware store that allowed me to get to a standard garden hose. And I might recommend that what you do is ultimately figure out, by talking to a local hardware store or someone that knows about plumbing a little, or doing a little research online and figuring out how to get from the weird stem that comes out of a given bilge pump to a standard garden hose threading. This allows you to thread on a garden hose and use it directly, which is quite nice. Like I mentioned before, if there's enough interest, I will go way deeper on this. We can do a separate video around crimping, maybe even working with a multimeter and understanding the flow of this electricity. But the critical thing that I wanted to get across is, for those of you that, like me, thought, boy, or think, it'd be amazing to be able to lift water out of a nearby pool or pond or cistern and use it in the garden. I don't need massive sprinkler systems. I just need to not have to dip a bucket every 5 minutes. This is a great way to go. Again, a bilge pump. I'm gonna put links in the description for all this. A solar panel that matches, and wiring can be for free. Before you buy a solar panel online, make some calls and connections. Does someone in your community or your family or friends tinker with electricity? Do you know folks that do off-grid? They probably have older panels that they no longer use. You're not looking for huge, beautiful panels. You're looking for smaller ones that are roughly appropriate for your pump. So see if you can find this for free first, get your wiring for free, and look for a bilge pump that somebody might be getting rid of or selling used. You might be able to do this all for $0 or very low cost. The alligator clips could even be switched out for just wire that's twisted and a little binder clip. So the black and black can be twisted together, and the red and red can be laid on top of one another with some sort of clip or even a stone, and that would work. So don't worry about electrocuting yourself or hurting yourself. At 12 volt systems at low wattage, it is incredibly safe, and try it out.